Hello and welcome to the Center of Excellence training series on tech. In this tutorial, we will cover how to access and create data sync feeds in iTAK. Let's get started. Simply put, data sync is a tool that creates a mission, also known as a feed, which is like a folder for custom data sets and is hosted within the iTAK server. Any data in the feed is synchronized to all iTAK app users who have subscribed to that feed. The sync happens immediately if the users are connected to the iTAK server, or will happen as soon as a user reconnects to the server. As a result, data sync is the best method in iTAK to ensure that all members of a team receive identical data when planning an operation. Conversely, items deleted by the data sync feed creator will disappear from users' maps. This is useful for decluttering maps after an incident is complete. Data sync feeds are associated with iTAK channels. This means a feed will only show up in iTAK if you have the channel associated with the feed toggled on. This provides an additional level of security for the feed. In this example, we will be using the Kotak system to access some wildland fire specific feeds. These are associated with the Colorado Wildland Fire MAC channel. So first, we will turn this channel on. In this example, we will load the Colorado MMA perimeters, Colorado FireGuard detections, and Colorado NIFS fire perimeter feeds. These are read-only feeds, meaning users cannot delete or modify the content of the feed for others. These feeds are made up of GIS data containing geospatial data on wildfires. They are automatically updated every 10 minutes by the Kotak system. Navigate to Data Sync on the bottom toolbar. Select Subscribe, then select Kotak or WoofTAK. Here, you will see the available feeds that you can subscribe to. Select the desired feeds, then subscribe to selected. You will be navigated to the main data sync page. Under Subscribe Feeds, you should see your selected feeds. Clicking on one will display the details page. You will also see the geospatial elements and attachments associated with the feed. Note that brand new feeds may not display anything until content is added. These items will be automatically added to your map pane. Clicking on the geospatial elements will navigate your map to its respective location. In this example, the items are part of a read-only data sync feed. If you attempt to delete an item from your map, it will simply reappear after a few minutes when your device syncs with the iTAK server. To hide a specific marker from your map, you must navigate to the marker, open the settings, select visibility, and check the hidden box. In order to delete the contents from a data sync feed, return to the main data sync page, then swipe left on the feed and select delete. From here, you can keep the contents or delete the contents. We highly recommend deleting the contents. If you keep the content, you will have to manually delete each one. To create a data sync feed, navigate to the Channels tool and ensure that you toggle off any channels that you do not want to share the feed with. This includes any system-wide channels such as aircraft tracking and Z initial setup. Then, return to the data sync tool and create feed. Name the feed and select a server. Then tap Save. You've now created the feed. You must save both times for the feed to be successfully created. To add items to the feed, return to the data sync and select Add Element. Select the element type and then choose your desired element. Ensure the dot next to your item of interest is selected and tap Add Elements. To delete the element from your data feed, under Geospatial Elements, simply swipe left on the element and select Delete. This concludes our tutorial for the iTAK Data Sync tool, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology. Thanks for watching.